Welcome everyone to Finding Life. My name is Jeff, and we're here to help you find life, enjoy life, and win in life. We are in episode 29, and we're in part three. And we're talking about not being interested. How can that be a problem in our lives? Mark chapter 4, verse 14 says that we sow words. And so that's what we talked about in episode number 28. We sow words. Our words are seed. And I made this statement: if we don't like what we have in life, we need to check up on what we've been saying or what we've been singing, our words. Okay? So verse 15, we just read into this. So verse 14, sower sows words. We sow words. We speak words, and when we speak words, we're sowing words. They're going to produce a harvest in our life. And so verse 15, immediately when we sow words, immediately when we speak the word of God, declare what we believe, what God said, there is a fight. And these are the ones on the wayside where the word is sown. When they have heard, Satan comes immediately and takes away the word that was sown in their hearts. So Satan comes to steal that word. Satan comes to steal the word. Matthew chapter 13, verse 19 says this: when anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, then the wicked one comes and snatches away what was sown in his heart. This is he who received seed by the wayside. So we're talking about wayside thinking. Wayside thinking. This is the first area of the playbook that we are exposing. Wayward thinking. Okay, the enemy's playbook, exposing this first part, wayward thinking. Now, notice it doesn't say Satan can come and just steal any word. No. Because, boy, that would put us at a disadvantage. We would hear the word and boom, he just comes in and steals it. But no, that's not what we see in the book of Matthew. It says the only word he is able to steal. So this first strategy, this first wayside thinking, part of the enemy's playbook that we're shining light on and exposing, is that he can only steal. He can only take and snatch away what we do not understand, what we are not interested in understanding. So let me read it this way: not being interested in knowing the kingdom, how he thinks and how he works and operates, how the kingdom functions and operates. If we're not interested, if we really don't care, I don't care. Well, if we don't care, then the word that we hear can immediately be taken, stolen. Why? Because we are not interested. We are not interested. And so that's the problem, okay? That's the enemy's playbook. First of all, is to get us to not understand, to not care, and not even be interested. Not being interested in understanding what God thinks, how he does things, and how the kingdom operates. That's how he can steal. Well, Matthew 6:33 says this, but we're to do what? We're to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, or his right way of doing things, and all these things will be added to us, increased to us. So in order for us to increase in the kingdom, we need to seek first the king, seek first his kingdom, his right way of doing things, how the kingdom functions and operates. We must be interested in knowing these things in order to enjoy fruitfulness and fulfillment in the kingdom of God. So Mark 4, verse 24 and 25 says this: then he said to them, take heed what you hear. With the same measure that you use, and the amount of thought and study, and then the amount of speaking that you put into what you hear, it'll be measured back to you, fruitfulness. And to you who hear, more will be given. For, because whoever has ears to hear, interest to hear, to him more will be given. But whoever does not have any interest to hear, really couldn't care less at all, even what he has will be taken away from him. Do you understand? We're just shined the light and exposed one of Satan's strategies in his playbook. The strategy of not being interested in God, his word and his way of doing things. That's how he, the devil, has free access into our life and can steal the word of God. Next time, we're going to get into the second way of thinking and acting and the result it produces. So we will see you in next time.